Welcome back to the Generation Gap, with the score standing at 45 for the younger generation, 75 for the older generation. Right now, let's play a cross-generation round. These questions cut across the Generation Gap. The material should be of equal interest to both generations. For this round, you work as a team. If you know the answer, hit the buzzer in front of you. The first person to hit the buzzer is the only one who can take a shot at the question. If you're right, you get 10 points, but be careful. If you're wrong, your team loses 10 points. You ready? Here we go. Who owns the record company known as Apple? Jonathan.
The Beatles.
Worth 10 points to you. Absolutely right. Name the American battleship that just went into action in Vietnam. Rita?
New Jersey.
Absolutely right, worth 10 points. Name one of the two Swedish cars sold in the United States. Mr. Gallagher.
Volvo.
Volvo and Saab, right, worth 10 points. What is Richard Nixon's middle name? Jonathan.
Milhouse.
Milhouse, worth 10 points. Name the skier who won 3 gold medals in the 1968 Winter Olympics.
Oh, no.
Mr. Gallagher? Time is up. Jean-Claude Killy. With 10 points to me, all right? We have right now 75 for the younger generation and 85 for the older generation. Let's get back right now to our Generation Gap questions and Rita White. Rita, we're going to bring back, just for you and you alone, one of the most romantic moments of the 20th century. Listen to this excerpt. Listen to this excerpt from an actual radio broadcast made on December 10th, 1936, before I was born, and look at the screen.
But you must believe me when I tell you that I have found it impossible to carry the heavy burden of responsibility without the help and support of the woman I love.
That should bring back a lot of memories. The problem is, what does it all mean to Rita? What did he give up to marry this woman? And let me tell you, Rita, he gave up a very good job. Okay, we need predictions right now from the older generation. Mrs. Murray says yes. Mr. Gallagher says yes. Mrs. Poliakin says no. Rita White, who is he or what did he give up?
Duke of Windsor, and he gave up his title to England.
You're absolutely right. Wait, 1 point. Good going. And that's 20 points for you, Rita. 10 points over here on correct predictions for the older generation. We have a tie score right now at 95 apiece. A good game going right here. Mrs. Poliakin, have you ever had trouble understanding your daughter?
Oh, often.
Often? Okay, Mrs. Poliakin. If she came home and asked you for bread to buy shades, would you know what she was looking for?
To buy shades?
Yes, Mrs. Poliakin. Bread to buy
shades.
She'd be looking for some money to buy some sunglasses, Mrs. Poliakin. Now listen, if she came home and asked you for money to buy a Guild, a Yamaha, or a Gretsch, what do you think she'd be asking for? Could we have some predictions from the younger generation? A Guild, a Yamaha, a Gretsch. Rita says yes. Jonathan says no. Nancy, the daughter, says no. What is a mother to do, Mrs. Poliakin? Okay.
She's to fake it, because it sounds like... What was it again?
A Guild, a Yamaha, or a Gretsch?
Listen, I always know when it's something I don't understand, it's about surfing or skiing. So is it about surfing?
No, Mrs. Poliakin, it's not about surfing or skiing.
How about food?
No, Mrs. Poliakin. Keep working on it, Mrs. Poliakin.
For that.
She would be looking for an electric guitar. No points for you.
I'd never buy her one.
All right, Mrs. Poliakin. We have 10 points worth of correct predictions over here for the younger generation. Nancy, we'll turn to the daughter right now. Our next question involves a great piece of film. It's a sequence from a Shirley Temple movie called Captain January. It features Shirley Temple and a young, up-and-coming song and dance man. Keep your eyes on him. They just don't make films like that anymore. And there's probably a very good reason why, I may add. Well, Shirley Temple's now involved in politics, and this young man has gone on to fame and fortune on television today. The question very simply is, Nancy, do you know who he is? And we need a prediction right now from the older generation. Her mother says no. Mr. Gallagher says no. Mrs. Murray says no. All right, Nancy. Nancy, who is it?
I know, you're right.
Take a guess.
And Gene Kelly.
Gene Kelly? A good guess, but a wrong answer.
Dan is like a sailor.
He's Buddy Epson. Oh. No points for you. 15 points over there for the older generation. And this is what Buddy Epson looks like today as the star of the Beverly Hillbillies. Mr. Gallagher, we've got a great question for you. One of the things that has helped create the generation gap has been the revolution in dancing. If you'll direct your attention center stage, we're going to show you some dance steps that are currently very popular. This is the boogaloo. This is called the tighten up. And this is called the shingling.
What?
Going to tell you the name of this dance they're now doing because that's your assignment. And let me add, Mr. Gallagher, should you accept this assignment and fail to identify this dance, these two people will self-destruct in 5 seconds. Okay, we need a prediction right now from the younger generation. Jonathan says yes, Nancy says yes, Rita White says no. Mr. Gallagher, what's the name of this dance?
Oh, heavens. Funky Broadway?
Funky Broadway? I'm sorry, Mr. Gallagher. It's called The Skate.
Oh.
Thank you, Tony. Nancy, thank you very much. We have no points for you, Mr. Gallagher. We have 5 points for Rita and her teammates. Right now, let's check the score. We have 110 points for the younger generation and 110 points for the older generation. So we have a game and a half going here, and we'll find out what happens with a cross-generation round right after this.